Hey everyone, this is your host Manik. Welcome to another video. So first of all, I would like to thank you guys for being so responsive and active on the community page. And a few days ago, I did a poll to find out how satisfied you guys were with the battery life on OnePlus devices. And like 80% of you were not happy with the battery backup on Oxygen OS 10. So today, I have something for you guys. And before we start, if you wish to stay notified about the latest videos, do click on that subscribe button and press the bell icon next to it. So for this tutorial, you need a PC, and what we will be doing at first is something every OnePlus user can do, even if you are not rooted. And the next part is something only rooted users can try. So let's start with the process now. And one more thing before we get to it. If you are like someone who starts gaming on their devices, like play PUBG for more than an hour on a stretch, you will still get lesser battery backup because of all the heat up that is causing the battery to drain even faster. So either tweak the settings to smooth and ultra so that this can be minimized and the battery can provide a better backup. And I tried it for days. Whenever I had a PUBG session on smooth and extreme for more than 30 minutes, the drain was almost 2 times faster. But if you are someone who uses the device for normal tasks, you can get some decent screen on times with this guide. So first of all, go to settings, click on privacy, now go to advanced. Now click on Google location history and turn it off. Now go back and click on ads and turn off both the options. And once again, click on the back button and click on usage and diagnostics. And now turn that off too. So all of this will make sure that the system isn't sending any unnecessary data in the background. Now in settings, go to Wi-Fi settings, click on Wi-Fi preferences and turn everything off. And this will make sure your device does not scan for any Wi-Fi network in the background. Now go back to location settings and here, click on Wi-Fi and Bluetooth scanning and turn both of these off. Now turn off emergency location service too. And after you have done all this, it is advisable to keep the location too off. If you are done with all this, go back and in system, click on experience improvement programs and turn off all the options as shown. And after this, make sure that you have chosen dark tone and dark wallpaper in customization option to save some of that extra juice. Now go back to utilities and turn off the pocket mode as well. So we are done in the settings part. And one last thing before we move to the more advanced part. In OnePlus launcher settings, turn off the step counter, parking location and cricket card as they keep refreshing in the background. Now coming to the more advanced part. What we are going to do is to remove all the unnecessary apps from the Oxygen OS, and you can choose what you wish to remove from these commands. And the app name is the last keyword of this command. So install the ADB drivers and OnePlus drivers from link in description area if you haven't done them already. Now connect your phone to PC and turn on USB debugging in developer options. Now click on OK. And in your PC, open command prompt as admin and just copy paste all the commands or choose whichever app you want removed as per your use case. Now in command prompt, type ADB space shell. Now just paste all the commands from description area and let them execute. So wait for a minute till the process stops and you're good to go. And after that, just restart your device and you're done with the first part. And for the second part, if your device is rooted, just install LKD modules in Magisk and choose the options as per your preference. So if you want better battery life, choose battery profile and so on. And I will leave it to balance for now and restart my device. And you can change these profiles from the LKD Manager app later. So don't worry about it, okay? It has 4 options to choose from. And I'll leave it to you guys to work around and let me know what results you get in the comment section down below. So for me, this module hasn't improved things drastically, but the overall heat up while gaming has been less till now. And you can give it a shot. And if you don't like, just disable it and reboot your device and you will be good to go. And that was it. Just try this setup out for a few days and let me know if you see some improvements, because I surely did. So if you like this video, do give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already. And I'll see you guys in the next one.